Hello and welcome to the 8th episode of Let's Play Fez. Last video we stopped here when we just came into the game again. Like, what did we have to do the very first time? Does anyone remember? Wait, what happened to the options? Yeah, it actually reset something, or for some reason it seemed a lot louder than it used to be. That's like way too loud, right? Hey! What's happening to the screen? No! Don't punish me! So yeah, this is Fez's way of fucking with you, I guess. The higher you get, the weirder your screen gets. And eventually it'll become really weird. No, it's just over time, not how high you get. It becomes more pixelated. And there's nothing wrong with the game, right? It's just the game's way of doing things. I have no clue why it does it. And I'll just let you enjoy the ride, I guess. I mean, it is a weird thing. So now you see the fabric of the Fez, or we assume it's the fabric of the Fez. You just keep on zooming down, real trippy. An infinite field of red squares. Great. And at the end of it, there's a cube. Maybe that's your head? I have no clue what this actually means, you know? So cubes within cubes. Weird again, different kind of colors, and this is like real trippy now. And we do have a repetition here of colors, it seems. It keeps speeding up as well. Music is a bit buggy, and then suddenly three chord lines. Zoom out a bit, follow the blue line. Follow the yellow background. And the line even splits up. I mean, like, what's the meaning behind all of this? There's like no meaning, just a trippy ending. And it's not even the full ending. I haven't actually ever experienced the full ending because I never got the 64 cubes yet. I will try to do that on this playthrough, of course. You see that everything on its basic is made out of tetronomicons. That's the name for those objects that we use as a code. But even those tetronomicons are then made out of what? Squares? Cubes? Dancing cubes? Maybe this represents atoms, sound waves. Like if you know how atoms work, they basically vibrate on the temperature they have. Like that's why something goes from solid state to fluid and then to a gas state, because of the vibration. And the more heat that comes to an atom, the harder it vibrates. And the harder it vibrates, the more easily it escapes from the rest. So that's why a solid state goes into a fluid state, because it's more vibrating, the atoms, and there's a more less density in between them. And then it goes to a gaseous form, because some start to escape with more vibration between the atoms. That's basically how heat works. And then suddenly, we're drumming. Drummer Fez. I mean, like, this ending is so trippy, so weird, but basically congratulates you in a way that you ended the game at 32 cubes. So far, you come to the credits screen, which you can obviously skip, which I will. A lot of credit goes to the guys that made this game. I mean, I really do love this game. And you can then go to Game Plus, it is, I think. Yes, start new Game Plus. And it is on that same save file. But for some odd reason, it seemed to have crashed here. I'll give you a black screen for a second and try to figure out what happened here. Okay, So it seems that just pausing and unpausing fixed it. It was really weird. Now there, when the game first came out on the, so you go back to everything being locked. If you go inside, you might think, well, maybe there's a qubit here, maybe there's something I need to do. Well, if you actually, oh, that's the wrong button. You can't actually turn things yet. You can't actually do anything yet. It's just basically the standard opening you had before. And it seems like, yeah, what am I doing here? What's New Game Plus, right? But you're still holding the fest. Like, you can climb. I mean, I could climb before. I still can turn, but why is it that I still have the fez and can't turn? I didn't have the fez in the very first playthrough. And the same thing happens. You also see that this guy has an eye patch, probably from his adventures, lost his eye. Obviously terrible for the guy, no one wants to lose an eye, right? So we do get a cube. And we come back to this area. So again, he says stuff we could translate, but it's not that important to us. Something comes out of the sky for us. What is it? What could be? It's sunglasses. Oh yeah, we look so cool now. So we turn again, break the cube. But basically what happened is that we now have first person view. Which just allows us to solve a lot more puzzles. Which is really cool. And again, the game pretends to crash. I don't know why it does that. I mean, it's something like, yeah, the world you had wasn't good enough and it's not complete, so it totally stops existing. And again, we come into a room, we wake up as usual, but this time we have the sunglasses, we can go first person. And we'll explore a new area, do some new puzzles on the next video. No, this was a short video, but I'll see you for the next one.